Now, Senator-elect Sonny Angara, may I ask the Honorable Commissioner Al A. Pareño to please proceed to the podium, sir.
National Board of Canvassers, we, the Chairman and Commissioners of the Commission on Election, sitting in bank as the National Board of Canvassers, do hereby proclaim Juan Engardo M. Angara, a Senator-elect in the May 13, 2019 national and local elections, to serve for a term of 6 years ending June 30, 2025 in accordance with Section 4, Article 6 of the Constitution of the Republic of the Philippines. Done this 22nd day of May 2019 at the Philippine International Convention Center, City of Pasay, Philippines. Signed, Sharif M. Abbas, Chairman, Ale Pareño, Commissioner, Louis Tito Guia, Commissioner, Maria Rowena Amelia Guanzon, Commissioner, Socorro Inting, Commissioner, Marlon Casquejo, Commissioner, Antonio Tico, Commissioner.
Senator Sonny Angara firmly clinches another stint at the Senate. Angara, the chairperson of the Senate Committees on Local Government and Ways and Means, ran under the administration's coalition. He was in Hugpong ng Pagbabago slate and in President Rodrigo Duterte's own lineup. In the 17th Congress, he pushed for the Tax Reform for Acceleration and Inclusion, or TREIN law, which lowered personal income taxes but increased excise taxes on fuel. While the TREIN law has been criticized for worsening poverty, Angara has said it has benefited millions of Filipino families. Now, Sonny Angara clinched 18.16 million votes. He pushed for laws to widen access to education through the passage of the Free College Law and the Unified Student Financial Assistance System Act to ensure that scholarships go to poor and deserving students. He is also one of the authors of the Universal Kindergarten Law, the Ladderized Education Act, the Open Learning and Distance Education Act, Youth Entrepreneurship Act, the law integrating moral history in the school curriculum, and laws to create universities in far-flung rural areas. Senator Angara believes that given the right opportunity, Filipinos will have a better quality of life. Thus, he authored laws to ensure sustainable jobs and decent working conditions. The law creating public employment service offices nationwide, the JobStart law, and the revised special program for the employment of students to help ease youth unemployment. He led the passage of the law that raised workers' take-home pay, the 13th month pay, and other bonuses by lowering and simplifying income taxes.